Khuddam, all these young people with great conviction, without any fear. They are, whatever duties are allocated to them in Pakistan, they are performing those duties. Some senior members, they write to me that we are surprised to see the feelings and the passions of these young people. The Ahmadiyya mosques in Pakistan nowadays, particularly the Ahmadiyya mosques, Hazur says, they have been declared as very sensitive places by our administration, but the young people, they go there. And the people who write to me, some people write to me that if somebody is unable to go somewhere because of the duty, that it doesn't mean that the young people are less. There are more people who are ready to go there. And they are always trying that if some substitute is to be taken, then we are ready to take the offer those services. And they, when they come back, then they say that, well, Alhamdulillah, we have come back safely, and if we don't come back, then Allah Almighty fulfill His promises in our favor. This is the faith which is being instilled in their hearts. It's a great zeal and passion which is there, which is being shown by these servants of the Messiah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah Almighty may and live and perpetuate these feelings and passions, and also protect them, these people. Today, the believers of the Messiah of Muhammad, they are writing a unique history today. And these are those youth who are fulfilling their covenants and promises. And for the establishment of unity, they are not lagging behind from anybody else. These are actually those people who are actually offering their life and honor and their wealth, and they are always ready to offer these sacrifices. And certainly these are the people, they are going to get the extreme pleasure of Allah Almighty. So following the path of righteousness and raising the standard of your worship, and try to get the pleasure of Allah Almighty more than ever before. Here, these people who are sitting in front of me are in Ijtimaga. Today is Khuddam Ahmadiyya's Ijtima, those who are sitting, and they are whom I am addressing directly. Those who, by the grace of Allah, those who have got the freedom of holding such gatherings, and as they like, whatever program they want to plan, they can act upon them. This is the freedom they enjoy. Those who have got the tarbiyat to make the tarbiyati programs, and those who have the freedom to formulate their tabligh programs, you should consider your responsibilities. You don't have to bring about a temporary change during these 3 days of ijtima, but try to instill a permanent change in you. Raise the standards of taqwa, righteousness, and raise the high status of your worship. The standards of your worship. This vulgar attraction of the West should not be tempting you or attracting you in that way, or making you indifferent. And always keep in your mind the sacrifices of those brothers who are strengthening their faith, those who are raising high the standard of Ahmadiyya, the true Islam. They are doing everything for that purpose. They are through their loyalties, and by fulfilling their they are offering every type of sacrifice in order to fulfill their covenants. So as a token of gratitude of this freedom, you have to raise the standard of your worship and your sacrifices. And similarly, you should also try level best to spread the message of Ahmadiyyat, and try to use each and every method of tabligh. There are modern ways and modern techniques are there, and the youth can use them more effectively. Now the Ahmadi youth, they have to play their role in two different fronts. The outer front, one is the reformation of the soul, is the inner front. And apart from that, the outside and the outer front are also two type. One is against Islam. They should take part in defense of Islam, and they have to defend Islam. And secondly, the attacks which are being made against Ahmadiyyat, they also have to defend those attacks. Websites are there, and very vulgar criticisms or objections are raised in them, you fill them with the message of truth. There should be an organized plan that in all these websites they are filled with the message of the truth that you have. If knowledge is deficient, then you get the help from the elders, from your missionaries. And now each and every khadam living in the world today, they should try to become a part of this campaign and scheme. Then you will be able to establish the unity of Allah and play the required role in that. The youth of the Messiah of Moses, they used to play their role in limited circles. But the servants of the Messiah of Muhammad, because of the new inventions and new means, you can bring about a big change in the whole world. So pay very special attention to this one. Allah Almighty enable all of them to do so. At the end, I would like to present one quotation from the writing of the Promised Messiah, Salatu Wasalam. He says, O my member of my community, Allah Almighty be with you all the time. Allah the Almighty, Allah Almighty prepare you for your journey of the hereafter as the companions of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they were prepared. Remember it fully, that this world is nothing. This is full of curse, that life which is spent for the world. And very unfortunate is that who has got all the concern for the benefit of this world. Such a person, if such a person is a member of my community, then it is a futile, without any purpose he enters himself into my community. He is like a dry branch which is not going to bear any fruit. Oh fortunate ones, you enter into this community with full force and follow that guidance which I have been given for your guidance. And believe Allah Almighty, worthy of worship, without setting up any partners in the heaven or the earth. Allah Almighty does not stop you from using the worldly means, but the person who leaves Allah Almighty and entirely depends on the means, he is a mushrik, setting up partners with Allah Almighty in order to have the pure hearts. Without becoming the pure hearts, there is no way of salvation. So have your hearts completely pure, and all these rancors and enmities, they should be thrown away. And there is always an instigation is there, and there are weaknesses. If there was no arrogance, nobody would have been a disbeliever. So become very humble and modest, and be kind to the poor people as you advise them to go to the paradise. So this advice can only be true if you are also thinking ill of those people. All the requirements should be done with the hearts filled with fear, and to pray too much in your prayers, so that Allah Almighty could attract you to yourself and purify your hearts. Because a human being is very weak, every weakness that is removed, that is removed with the help of Allah Almighty. And unless a person gets the help from Allah Almighty, no one is able to do so. Islam is not only this much, that just as a ceremony you declare yourself those who pronounce kalima, but the truth, the reality of kalima is that your souls should be at the threshold of Allah Almighty. And these things, they become preferred by you at every point. And Allah Almighty enable us to act upon all these instructions given by the Promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam.
Alhamdulillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل واللسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر.